With the 2020 Tokyo Olympics having come and gone, some of us have been feeling nostalgic. Since nostalgia is great for reminiscing, we thought it'd be great to catch up with Carl Lewis, who just so happens to be a favorite when it comes to the track and field division of the games. The rich lifestyle of Carl Lewis. Frederick Carlton Lewis, as he's formally called, made a name for himself as a track and field star, competing in a number of running events as well as the men's long jump competition. In the end, he brought home a grand total of 9 gold medals and 1 silver for the United States, causing him to be an absolute legend of the Olympics who will continue to be remembered for the days to come. This isn't a video about the life and times of Carl Lewis. We're here to discover the type of lifestyle that the former Olympian has chosen to live over the past few years and whether retirement has indeed been good for this 60-year-old legend. In order to answer this question, though, we do have to look at how long the man was competing for. This answer may surprise you. As it turns out, Carl Lewis doesn't just live a wealthy lifestyle, but a busy one as well, filled to the brim with high-intensity workouts that are sure to make the youngest of us sweat, his extended family. When it comes to the life and times of Carl Lewis, nothing is more important than family. He has made this abundantly clear throughout the running of his largely lucrative career. Flashback to his first big win, and you'll hear him in a post-race interview discussing just how thankful he was to have his parents in his life. According to reports, he wasn't exactly shy to show this either. His father, William Lewis, and mother, Evelyn Lawler, would on occasion accompany the superstar on lavish holidays in faraway places. This was, however, only when the track and field star was able to take time away from his busy schedule. It's a lot of time and effort to become a legend in your field, after all, and Carl was always lucky enough for his parents to understand this. He also grew up alongside 2 older brothers and a younger sister, all of whom who have been treated by the star back in his heyday. But this wasn't the be-all and end-all of his spoiling antics when it came to family. Carl Lewis went on to marry Maria Lewis, with whom he had a beautiful son, Bakim Lewis. Not a day went by that his wife and son found themselves without anything that could ever need to be happy. The families were often brought together by huge holidays, such as Christmas, where a large number of presents were set aside for one another. In other words, it can be said that the lifestyle of Carl Lewis was not only rich when it came to his actual financial situation, but rich according to the family relations and memories he was treated to along the way. And while we doubt that his spoiling of them would have changed any of this, there's no doubt that he spent a fair share of money on his favorite people, his business presence, and overall marketability. As many years in the track and field division would have taught him, life can hand you some peculiar lemons at times. It's for that reason that even after retirement, Carl Lewis decided to retain an image that companies and businesses would be proud of having attached to their products. Surprisingly enough, Lewis has been through a bit of a roller coaster when it came to the endorsements offered to him. A few years ago, rumors began to spread that he was gay, which unfortunately tarnished his image despite how often he had denied this information, led to him being dropped by one of his biggest sponsors, Coca-Cola. But after the company came to its senses, Lewis decided he was far too good for the brand, instead investing some of his own money into a lucrative deal with Nike. And as it turns out, this was a pretty impressive investment to make, with Nike still having him endorse a variety of products to this day. He knew how to market himself, but it wasn't just his athleticism that Lewis wanted to be known for. He also wanted to be known for his impressive business ethic and acting prowess. Although his acting career never took off, the man ended up making a killing by starting his own business line that went on to sell foods, perfume, beverages, and the like. In fact, he even invested in a line of restaurants which would later be called Fat Lewis Burger, a chain that Americans now love. Lewis went on to make a number of great investments in himself so that he would not just be remembered as a world-class athlete. It's likely because of these initial investments that he has been able to retain a massive net worth of around $20 million. His eating habits. Speaking of marketing prowess, Carl Lewis has been a vegan for as long as we can remember and has on many occasions made it known that veganism is a lifestyle was something that helped him with his overall athleticism. After stating that the lifestyle he adopted in his late 20s was perfect for improving his performance on the track, Lewis encouraged people to live the way that he was. Not in a preachy way, of course, but a motivational way in which he would inform carnivorous athletes what they could be eating for the same benefit. But as any vegan or partial vegetarian will know, food that falls into this category can be incredibly expensive. This is especially the case when discussing meat and cheese replacements, with many products costing high-profile clients in the thousands of dollars. As it turns out, things were no different for Carl Lewis. The man has also been known to indulge in herbal teas that are brought in from across the globe, which have cost a significant amount of his net worth over the years. That being said, this is just one of those decisions that he has stuck with for just over 30 years. And luckily for him, he had the money to back his decision up entirely. Not everyone can afford vegan replacements and fresh fruit every single morning, after all. His incredible home. As we mentioned earlier, Carl has a family of his own, so it shouldn't surprise you to hear that he wanted to spend a significant amount of money on a proper home in which they would feel both safe and comfortable. This is probably one of the smartest decisions ever made by the former Olympian as well, as an investment in an immovable property is considered by many to be one of the best investments you could ever make. Unlike movables, immovable property has the tendency to appreciate in value rather than depreciate. This means that as the years go by, the property is likely going to rise in value as opposed to it decreasing in value, making it worth more down the line when you decide to sell it once and for all. We already know that Lewis is an incredible investor, so let's dive into the property that he decided to buy for himself. According to reports, this all started when he bought a Pacific Palisades home back in 2002 for around $1.75 million. The home, which as we mentioned can be found in the Pacific Palisades region, has impressive ocean views and comes in at an incredible size of around a third of an acre. Came complete with a swimming pool, spa, fishing pond, and a generous amount of gardening space that allowed the family to plant a range of fruit trees to supplement their diet. As for living space, the mansion supplied them with 4 bedrooms and 4.5 bathrooms. A master bedroom was also included, which came with an attached area for extra space. This property was, however, sold by the family in July of 2010 for an amount of approximately $2.5 million. No information's been released as of yet regarding his new home, but there's no doubt that he would have decided to upgrade his exercising routine. Last but not least, we just had to mention the rigorous exercise routine that Carl Lewis follows at the moment. At the age of 60, the man still has a six-pack, which shows how much work he still puts into his health and body. He not only attends a high-profile gymnasium, but has a range of gym equipment at home, which he likes to use when he doesn't feel like going out. He also loves to spend a large amount of money on one of his favorite hobbies, which just so happens to be cycling. All in all, this adds up to more than the average professional still spends on exercise, and we can't help but think that Lewis never actually retired in the first place. What do you think of his impressive lifestyle? Be sure to let us know in the comments section down below.